Aerial renders are some of the most jaw-dropping images you can create for a project. They capture scale, context, and impact like nothing else. But let's be real, they're also a pain to make. So when done right, aerial renders evoke emotion, showcase all of the work you put into the design, and let's be honest, just look insanely cool. So traditionally, creating an aerial render meant modeling the entire surrounding context to get something semi-realistic. And we all know that's brutal. Either you spent a whole week crafting an ultra detailed cityscape just for a few seconds of animation, or you go to the conceptual route with white boxes, planes, and a whole lot of But what if there was another way? A way to get detailed, realistic aerial renders without spending days modeling everything. Well, with V-Ray and its new support for Gaussian splats, that's exactly what you can do. So let's get started. And hey, if you're in a hurry, I've added timestamps below so you can jump straight to the parts that interest you the most. Before we dive in, I need to quickly explain three simple things. First, what a Gaussian splat is. Second, how you can create one. And third, how to import them into SketchUp. So what exactly is a Gaussian splat? At its core, Gaussian splatting is based on 3D Gaussians, which are these tiny blobs of color and opacity scattered in 3D space. They don't act like traditional polygons, but instead they blend together to form incredibly detailed photorealistic renders when projected onto a 2D image. So why should you care? So for architects and visualization artists, this means faster, more interactive 3D presentations without needing a monster GPU, high quality scans of real world environments, ideal for site analysis and context modeling, and integration with game engines for interactive walkthroughs and next level presentations. Now, how do you actually create one? Let's get into it. For this example, I'll be using the website Polycam, which you can use with a free trial and test it out. Here, you can filter your search for models that specifically are splats and download them and use them in your 3D models. Or you can also create your own Gaussian splat. To create your own splat, let's click on the Create button and select Gaussian splat. Here you can either upload images or a video, so I did some tests to see if I could create some models from Google Earth sites like this one. So I went to Google Earth, selected a site, and started recording my screen and made sure to record it all from all types of angles. The more information you have on your site, the better it will be represented. And of course, you have to take into account that the longer the video is, the heavier the output file will be. So I'll try to keep it under 2 minutes for now. After I recorded my screen, I imported it into Premiere Pro to crop the borders and only keep the Google Earth visuals. Then I imported the video into Polycam, and it took about 40 minutes to create the model. With this technique, I created three different models of three different sites of Google Earth to test out how these different models could look and if they were somehow usable for architectural purposes. The thing is, these models will be limited by the resolution of Google Earth, and depending on your site, it might have some 3D information available or it might look flat. So you want to take that into account as well. Now, ideally, if you had some drone footage of your site, it could work 10 times better than this technique. It could represent better each texture and get closer details. So if you have the chance to get some drone footage of your site and then turn it into a splat and place your project, this would be a really good workflow. You wouldn't have to model your whole site. Now let's import these models into SketchUp. So click on the model, click on download, and select splat PLY and wait for it to download. After you download it, let's open SketchUp. Now in your V-Ray tab, let's go to Import Prati, and here I'll select my splat and import it. After importing, I'll open my V-Ray Asset Editor and select my splat. And on the SketchUp view, you will see a point cloud that doesn't really say much and it may be hard to read and understand. So I'll open my V-Ray interactive window and put it on one side of my screen so I can really see what I'm working with. Now we will see in our asset editor a series of options. Some of these are pretty self-explanatory. So I can increase the preview percentage. That way I can get a point cloud that is much more dense and defined. Also, there is a chance that the scale of the model might be off, so you might have to increase the scale factor. This part can take a while. Hopefully there's an easier way of scaling it precisely in the future. Meanwhile, I can import a model from Chaos Cosmos for reference and change the scale factor as many times as possible. Here we have some more options, but I'll explain these further down in the video. For now, let's take a look at our model. So as you guys can see, a Gaussian splat is a pretty interesting method for the amount of visual information that we have in our model. It's also pretty lightweight. If you were trying to create this whole model in 3D, it would first of all be really, really heavy. And second of all, applying all of these textures so it can look realistic would be impossible. Now, of course, this is a technology that is in constant development, and there are some things that can be perfected. So for example, if you zoom out, you can see a lot of irregular blobs that look a bit weird and sort of translucent. So in some areas, it's not really solid, and you can see through the terrain, which for some scenarios is not ideal. Also, you can see if we get really close, the quality of the texture looks a bit low. So for now, I imagine it can work for aerial images that don't require that much detail. And I mean, supposing I already had my architecture model finished, I would just import it into my splat, create a general aerial render, and that's basically it. The whole process would take less than 2 hours in comparison to the workflow of creating the entire context and trying to make it look realistic. Okay, so now that you've seen how to create a splat and import it into SketchUp, I want to try to create an aerial render with this same technique. So we're going to go back onto Polygon to search for a splat of higher quality and import it into our model, hopefully a splat that was created with some drone footage. So in the search bar, you can filter your search by file type, start searching, and I think these city blocks right here are in a good quality to create this render. So I'll download the model and now open SketchUp. Go to import proxy, select the proxy, and import it. Now I'll open the asset editor, select the splat, flip the axis, and increase the scale. Again, this can take you some time to get the hang of and be precise. For this model, I scaled it up to 20,000, and I still think it wasn't as precise as I would like it to be. Now, I'll go onto my Chaos Cosmos library and type building in the search bar. So for this image, I'll use this skyscraper model from the Cosmos library, but in your case, you would either copy your finished architecture file or import the splat in the finished file. Now import this building onto your model. I'll place it towards the center of the splat. Again, this process can be much easier if you open the V-Ray interactive rendering and try to see where your building will be placed. So that's what we're gonna do right now. Here, I'll also slightly increase the scale of my model just so it stands out from the rest. Now, there are many things that are still wrong with this image that we need to fix. First, our skyscraper is receiving light from the opposite side of the splat, which obviously is not ideal. So our model is grabbing the light from the default sun and V-Ray, while the Gaussian splat doesn't need an external light to illuminate. It already has the light that it came with. The Gaussian splat illuminates by itself. So what we need to do is match the V-Ray light to the Gaussian light. So I'll go to the asset editor, click on the light icon, then select the sunlight, activate custom orientation, and we can see that the sunlight is coming from the right side of the screen and there are hard shadows on the left side of the volumes. So I'll adjust the sun and try to match it as best as possible. And this looks much better. Now we can also see that we don't have any reflections, refractions, or shadows of our building. So it doesn't look very real. Let's go to our asset editor, select the Gaussian splat, and activate the options reflections, refractions, and cast shadows. This way, if I render my image again, I can see that the skyscraper looks much better. It's receiving reflections from the Gaussian splat and also shadows. But we still don't have a shadow from our skyscraper onto the splat. Now, since this splat is not an actual solid, it can't receive shadows, but we can create a basic volume that can act as a shadow catcher. So let me show you how. So first, I'll try to create a basic model of the surroundings where the building will cast some shadows. You don't want to spend too much time on this, just create a basic model. So more or less something like this. I can correct it later, but for now it serves the purpose just fine. Now I'll open the V-Ray asset editor, go to materials, right click and select wrapper. Now on the wrapper, I'll right click and apply to the selection. In the material settings, I want to make sure the base material is none. The alpha contribution is black alpha. The matte option is on and the shadow option is on. Now, if I click on interactive render again, I'll see the shadows projected onto the volumes, but the volumes will be hidden. Now, I can also import things like trees from the Chaos Cosmos library. So I'll go to the library, search for the trees I like the most, and import them into the base of our skyscraper. I'll do this for some more trees and place them around our image. Now, this is looking pretty good. And take into account that this workflow can speed up your rendering times and help you create many aerial renders with very little effort. Of course, for the moment, some of these Gaussian splats are low quality, but with future updates, I imagine all of this will be improved and easier to work with. After I have my final render, I can always import it into Photoshop, do some color correction, general image correction, and I can even use AI to improve some parts that for now look in regular quality. So this is the final render from V-Ray. This is with the improvements in Photoshop, and this is with some slight AI adjustments. Pretty cool, right? Now, these videos wouldn't be possible without the awesome support of Chaos, the sponsor of today's video. Huge shout out to the team at Chaos, not only for sponsoring this video, but also for genuinely supporting the content that I want to create. They're always open to my ideas and help bring these cool tutorials to life for you guys. So if you're looking to dive deeper into V-Ray for SketchUp, use Gaussian splats and use all the features, I've dropped a link below where you can download it, test it out, and start creating your own aerial renders. And honestly, I'd love to see what you come up with. If you make something cool, tag me or drop it in the comments. And if you want to see all the latest V-Ray for SketchUp updates, I've got a full breakdown right here in this link, or you can find the link in the description of the next video. Now, if you find this video helpful, hit that like button, subscribe, and drop a comment down below. Will you be trying Gaussian splats in V-Ray? What's the biggest struggle you face when creating aerial renders? And what features do you wish V-Ray had for SketchUp? Please, I'm dying to know. Comment down below. Let's keep the conversation going in the comments section. And as always, thank you for watching. Check out more rendering tutorials right here on this playlist. And that's it. See you in the next one. Bye.